The two lords, Nithai Gaurachandra, are very merciful. They are the essence of all incarnations. The specific significance of this incarnation is that they introduce a process of chanting and dancing that is simply joyful. My dear brother, I request that you just worship Lord Chaitanya and Nityananda with firm conviction and faith. One wants to be Krishna conscious by this process. One has to give up his engagement in sense gratification. One simply has to chant Hare Krishna, Hari Hari, without any motive. My dear brother, just try and examine this within the 3 volts. There is no one like Lord Chaitanya or Nityananda. Their merciful qualities are so great that upon hearing them, even birds and bees cry and stones melt. But Lochan Das regrets that I am entrapped by sense gratification since I have no attraction for the lotus feet of Lord Chaitanya, Lord Nityananda. Then Amaraj, the superintendent of death, is punishing me by not allowing me to be attracted by this moment. Shri Lochan Das Thakur ki chai. It's very wonderful translation, actually. Which actually gives significance of why Mahaprabhu came. You all there for Sankirtan seminar? We had a couple of weeks ago. Who were there? Nice. So this is a continuation of that whole program. We want to do some more. We want to test you guys remember those or not. This is like an exam today. After your... this is my first sem exam today. Today is a monthly Sankirtan festival. This is actually what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wants. You remember what are the two things what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wants? What is this moment? Anybody remembers two things? You're saying something? Yeah, Prabhu said two things of this mission. All the Krishna conscious movement, if you summarize, there are two parts of it. What is the first part? Chant Hare Krishna. That is the first part. What is the second part? Teach others. Good. You remember second part nicely. So everybody say once again, what is our Krishna conscious movement? Teach others. Chant Hare Krishna. Teach others? Teach others? Chant Hare Krishna? Very simple, right? This is what whole Mahaprabhu mission is all about. So, it looks very simple. Sometimes things are very tough. You all agree? It's because the material world is very harsh, correct? Things are very, very harsh sometimes. That's the reason this verse, what we picked today, there is very nice verse, Prabhupada purport, to remember the whole verse about, if you just remember Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, any tough thing become very easy, right? If you don't remember Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, even simple thing, looks very, very big, right? So, we'll read the verse and we'll read translation and then we'll basically speak few things about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and more of remembering or brushing up our whatever we heard in seminar. You're all okay? Hare Krishna. Katanchana smrute yasmin Dushkaram sukaram bhavet Dushkaram sukaram bhavet Vismret viparitam shayat Vismret viparitam shayat Sri Chaitanyam Namamitam Sri Chaitanyam Namamitam కథాంచనాస్మృతేయస్మిన్ దుష్కారం సుకరం భవేత్ విస్మరేత్ విపరీతం శయత్ శ్రీచైతన్యం నమామితం. కథాంచన సమ్హౌ ఆర్ అదర్ స్మృతే బై రిమెంబరింగ్ యస్మిన్ హూమ్ దుష్కరం డిఫికల్ట్ థింగ్స్ సుకరం ఈజీ భవేత్ బికమ్ విస్మృతే బై ఫర్గెటింగ్ హిమ్ విపరీతం జస్ట్ ద ఆపోజిట్ సయత్ బికమ్ శ్రీచైతన్యం లార్డ్ శ్రీచైతన్య మహాప్రభు నమామి ఐ ఆఫర్ మై రెస్పెక్ట్ ఒబేసెన్సెస్ తమ్ ఆన్ టు హిమ్. ట్రాన్స్లేషన్ ప్రిపర్డ్ బై హిస్ డివైన్ గ్రేస్ భక్తి వేదాంత స్వామి శ్రీల ప్రభుపాద్కి. ట్రాన్స్లేషన్ థింగ్స్ దట్ ఆర్ వెరీ డిఫికల్ట్ టు డూ బికమ్ ఈజీ టు ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ ఇఫ్ వన్ సమ్హౌ ఆర్ అదర్ సింప్లీ రిమెంబర్స్ లార్డ్ చైతన్య మహాప్రభు. బట్ ఇఫ్ వన్ డస్ నాట్ రిమెంబర్ హిమ్ ఈవెన్ ఈజీ థింగ్స్ బికమ్ వెరీ డిఫికల్ట్. టు దిస్ లార్డ్ చైతన్య మహాప్రభు ఐ ఆఫర్ మై రెస్పెక్ట్ ఒబేసెన్సెస్ ప్రిపర్డ్. ఇన్ హిస్ బుక్ చైతన్య చంద్రామృత శ్రీల ప్రబోధానంద సరస్వతి సేస్, వన్ హూ రిసీవ్స్ అ లిటిల్ ఫేవర్ ఫ్రమ్ ద లార్డ్ బికమ్ ఏ సో ఎగ్జాల్టెడ్ దట్ హీ డస్ నాట్ కేర్ ఈవెన్ ఫర్ లిబరేషన్ విచ్ ఇస్ సాట్ ఆఫ్టర్ బై మెనీ గ్రేట్ స్కాలర్స్ అండ్ ఫిలాసఫర్స్. సిమిలర్లీ ఎ డివోటీ ఆఫ్ లార్డ్ చైతన్య కన్సిడర్స్ రెసిడెన్స్ ఇన్ ద హెవెన్లీ ప్లానెట్స్ ఎ విలో ద విస్ప్. He surpasses the perfection of mystic yoga power because for him the senses are like snakes without broken fangs. A snake is very fearful and dangerous animal because of his poison fangs. But if these fangs are broken, the appearance of snake is no cause for fear. The yoga principles are meant to control the senses, but there is no scope for senses of one engaged in service of the Lord to be dangerous like snakes. Nice point to remember. You want me to read once again? The yoga principles are meant to control the senses, but there is no scope for the senses of one engaged in service of the Lord to be dangerous like snake. These are the gifts of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. The Hari Bhakti Vilas confirms that difficult things become easy to understand if one remembers Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and easy things become very difficult to understand if one forgets him. We actually see that even those who are very great scientists in the eyes of general public cannot understand very simple idea that life comes from life because they do not have the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. They defend the false understanding that life comes from matter, although they cannot prove that this is a fact. Modern civilization, therefore, progressing on the basis of this false scientific theory, is simply creating problems to be solved by so-called scientists. The author of Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita takes shelter of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to describe the pastimes of his appearance as a child, because one cannot write such transcendental literature by mental speculation. One who writes about the Supreme Personality of Godhead must be especially favored by the Lord. Simply by academic qualification, it is not possible to write such literature. Om Agnanati Mrindasya Agnana Anjana Shalakaya Chakshunmitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Sri Chaitanya Manobishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutalem Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Subdhantikam వందేహం శ్రీగురుం శ్రీతపదకలం శ్రీగురుం వైష్ణవాంశ శ్రీరూపం సాగృజాతం సగణ రఘునాథాంబితం తం సజీవం సాద్వైతం సావధూతం పరిజన సైతం కృష్ణ చైతన్యదేవం శ్రీరాధాకృష్ణపాదాన్ సగణలలిత శ్రీ విశాఖాంబితం హే కృష్ణ కరుణా సింధు దీనబంధు జగత్పతే గోపేశ గోపికాకాంత రాధాకాంత నమోస్తుతే తప్త కాంచన గౌరాంగే రాధే వృందావనేశ్వరి ఋషభానుసుతిదేవి ప్రణమామి హరిప్రియే వాంఛాకల్పతరూభ్య కృపాసింధుభైవ చ పతితానాం పావనేభ్యో వైష్ణవేభ్యో నమో నమః. జయ శ్రీకృష్ణ చైతన్య ప్రభు నిత్యానంద శ్రీ అద్వైత గదాధర శ్రీవాసాది గౌరభక్తవృంద. హరే కృష్ణ 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 హరే హరే, హరే రామ హరే రామ 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 హరే హరే. హరే కృష్ణ. ఐ సీక్ బ్లెస్సింగ్స్ ఫ్రమ్ శ్రీల ప్రభుపాద్ ఫౌండర్ ఆఫ్ ఇస్కాన్, also seek blessings from all the Vaishnavas and Vaishnavis, because you're all very dear to the Lord, and by your mercy I can speak something which is beneficial for all of you. I also thank devotees who came forward and organized this today's program. This verse especially, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking, very few things Prabhupada's explaining, that just by remembering Lord Chaitanya, or just by engaging in the mission of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we feel blissful. And Prabhupada also writes that just by engaging in this mission, our senses will be like, Prabhupada's writing, our senses will be like for a snake removing the fangs. So it's very, very, very touching, because we living entity in conditioned life, we all struggle with senses, correct? At least me. So to get out of that senses, or to engage, to get out of that sense gratification process, even we heard this verse just now. What is the... So the holy name delivers everything, but what is the requirement? What is the requirement is Shraddha, and also we should come out of the sense gratification process, correct? If you remember the purport what we read of Shloka, unless we do pure service to Krishna, or pure service to the movement, that is the only qualification to take the mercy of Lord Chaitanya, right? So, because Lord Chaitanya is merciful, but we have to be purified, correct? So, like I was hearing, like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is very, very, like Krishna is very straight. Sarva dharmam parityaja mam ekam sharanam vraja. Unless you don't surrender, he will not give mercy, right? But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is more merciful, right? At least, like, if you want to write exam for Krishna, if you write for 80 marks, he'll put 80 marks. But for Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, if you write for 70, he'll give 80 marks. Right? But if you ask, you know, I cannot even write for 70, then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, go to Nityananda Mahaprabhu. Right? So if you go to Nityananda Mahaprabhu and ask, you know, I cannot even write for 60, but I need full marks. That's what we say, right? We want everything shortcut, easy process, right? Then Nityananda Prabhu says, okay, just write your name and go. Come here, write your name and go. Then we normally ask, oh, we have to come all the way. Bangalore has so much traffic here. We can't even come. Correct? Then Nityananda Prabhu says, okay, go to Srila Prabhupada. He will give some trick. Right? So if you go to Srila Prabhupada, Prabhupada will ask, okay, what did Mahaprabhu says? What did Krishna says? He says, we have to, if you write 80, you'll get 80. Mahaprabhu says, if you write for 70, you'll get 80. But Nitai said, at least you should come here and give name. I said, I cannot do that also, because we want everything shortcut, right? Then Prabhupada says, You don't even come here. Just stay home and chant, read. That is the merciful of Srila Prabhupada. So all these acharyas in parampara are helping us to make it things easy, right? But we're still in hiding zone, correct? It's very difficult for us to even do the simple things because we're so conditioned and caught up in this material world. So that's the reason this process is very, very simple. If you, because whole Krishna consciousness, like we discussed, there are only two parts of Krishna consciousness. That is chant Hare Krishna and teach others. But to do this process, to understand this process, Prabhupada simplified more even, right? He gave these books and he gave service, we gave temples. We have everything here, correct? So the only thing is we have to be little sincere, right? Like Shraddha, little sincerity will always keep us in this mission, right? Because if you're not have the desire of to be engaged in this movement, even nobody can help us, right? So the program, what we were planning to envision is, when we go out in spreading this Chaitanya Mahaprabhu mission, because that's what Acharya wants, right? When Mahaprabhu went to Bengal, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu stayed 18 years in Puri, right? He was in a Gambhir. You've been to the Gambhir, the place where Mahaprabhu stays? It's a very small place. Even the Mahaprabhu is very, very tall. You know how you fit that place. Mahaprabhu was, when Nityananda Prabhu came to meet Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Mahaprabhu said, you know, you don't have work here, you don't have any service here. Go back to Bengal. And he told Nityananda Mahaprabhu that just give this holy name to everybody, right? So every day, Haridas Thakur and Nityananda Mahaprabhu, what they used to do? They used to go and knock the doors and request everybody to chant Hare Krishna. They used to go door to door and shop to shop, right? This is our mission. That's what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told. You should go door to door and beg everybody in Bengal, even illiterates. Like, don't leave anybody, right? So that is a mission of our old parampara. What did Nityananda Prabhu said? He went to every door and knocked and begged everybody, please take up this mission, right? What did he say? Please take up this mission. When we go out for book distribution, we should have same mood, right? We normally tell, when we go out, if we don't have that humility, it's very difficult people to accept you, right? Why somebody has to give respect to you, right? When we go out, right? As soon as you go out and give the book to others, what other person thinks? Who is this guy? Correct? Why he is coming here? What's in it for him? And third thing he thinks it, what's in it for me? Correct? It's all business. If you go to all the malls in Bangalore, everybody is selling something. Correct? Because they're doing business. Correct? But if you can answer these three questions, who are you, who I am, why I'm here, what's in it for you, then you're done. Your book is gone. It's called Sambandha Abhideya Prayojana. This is philosophy. Correct? If you can make Sambandha Abhideya and Prayojana, tell the what is the use. So that's very important. Right? If you don't have that humility, you know, yeah, this is Bhagavad Gita, You are a fallen soul. You are a conditioned soul. You know, you have to take this book or else you'll go to hell. Anybody will take? This is truth, but nobody will accept it. Correct? The only thing what, we won't get appreciated by anybody. Only thing appreciates other devotees is humbleness, is purity. Correct? If you want to become a big businessman, somebody wants followers as a businessman, what do people see in businessman? I'm in Bangalore. More money, right? If you're a businessman, you should have more money. Correct? How many business people are here? A lot. If you're a politician, why do people go for politician? Problems. And you're considered a big leader when you have more followers, right? Why do people come for Hare Krishna devotees? Any guess? Happy, right? You just have to give book and smile, that's it. Correct? We say Hare Krishna, chant Hare Krishna and be happy. We should also be happy. Right? Why do people take? Because we are happy. Right? They see us, oh, these guys are happy. Because if I take this book, I'll also be happy. But if we go to them and said, money, I want, this guy will give money, 500, 1000, 200. Then he will know, these guys came for money. And if I take the book and read, I will also become like these people. Right? They think like that, correct? People are very smart. Agreed? They do face reading. Face is index of the mind. Correct? So, if you have that, whatever the humility, and we can easily, people can see us. Correct? How does it come? We all have affluent faces here, smiling faces. How does it come? Yeah, nice. Sadhana, correct? If you have good sadhana, we'll all become happy, correct? If we don't do our sadhana that day, if we don't chant our rounds in the morning, how do we feel? So many things in the mind, right? You have to do this, this, that, but end of the day, we don't do anything. Correct? You all experience? If you don't finish our rounds in the morning, how do you feel? Right? We feel morose, correct? We like to do so many things, but end of the day, we feel frustrated. Correct? So, unless we have strong sadhana, we cannot be happy. Our face cannot be affluent. Correct? That's the reason if you are going out every day, at least for Sankirtan book distribution, you should take the mirror and watch. You are happy or not? Right? You should see at least yourself. Are you able to just give this mission to everybody? It's important, correct? Even to construct, like we're constructing a temple, right? Big temple. Yes? We're all in it? Yes. To construct a temple, you need foundation. You know how much people spend for foundation? Typically for any building? Any building people here? Typically 20% of money goes to the foundation. If you're spending like a 1 crore, how much is our temple cost, Prabhu? Budget? Expectation? 12 crores. We'll say 10 crores for easy math. For 10 crores, what is the 20%? Nice. How much is 20% of 10 crores? 2 crores. How much, Prabhu? 20%. 10% is 1 crore. 20% is 2 crores. But if you come to temple, what everybody will see? Nice deities, nice decoration. But anybody will say nice foundation? No, correct? They don't see foundation, it's not visible, right? But that's very important, correct? If you don't have foundation, you may look nice, Kantimala, Tilak, nice dressed, nicely dyed also. But people don't get attracted, right? Because our eyes will say the truth. Oh, this guy came for money. Money, 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 money. We're not here for money, right? Krishna is all rich, right? Jagannath is very rich. And we are going out for, why do we go out? Why we want to give this mission to everybody? First thing, all seminar questions, okay? Exam going on here. We go out for self-purification, right? We don't go out for anything. If you have some desire of going out and getting something, you'll be frustrated. Trust me. We did this a lot. Don't go expect anything. Why do we go out? For self-purification. Everybody say this. Why do we go out? How do we purify? Yes. Because there is an unknown factor. Correct? If I knock a door, anything can happen. Correct? Somebody has called you. Somebody even slap in India. It might happen to you. Right? In Bangalore, people are very soft. They're very loving people. So they don't do that. But anything can happen. Correct? Anything can happen. Right? That's the unknown we have to hug. Right? If we're staying at home and closing our doors and chanting, right? That's a controlled environment. Correct? If you're in temple, everybody is nice. Hare Krishna Prabhu. Nice kirtan. Everything is nice. Correct? Everybody respects you. Correct? When we go out, that's not the case. Correct? We all face experience. We should, like, we go out, you know, I'm a Hare Krishna devotee. Please, you know, I'm wearing garland. Respect me. Anybody does it? No. We all seen it. We all go out, right, every day. So that's the unknown we have to hug, right? That is actually gives self-purification. The book distribution is actually self-purification. It keeps you awake, right? Book distribution is preaching, right? What we are going there? What we are telling everybody? Just glorifying Krishna, right? As soon as you give the book, what do you say? This is, what do you say? Anybody? What do you say? As soon as you give the book, what do you say? Anything is correct. Because we don't know. Nice. Good point. What do you say, Prabhu? Nice. Right? We explain about this. Correct? If we don't explain it, means we are glorifying Krishna. That is actually preaching. Right? Especially when we were in Tirupati yesterday, I just came from Tirupati, we had a Sankirtan program, similar program for temple inmates. Not like you have so much responsibilities. There are temple inmates, we had a morning program, seminar. We all went out to Govindaraja Swami. You had darshan anytime Govindaraja Swami? Yes? Nice temple, correct? It's a good spot. You love it if you go there. So we all went out. all these boys were young boys, you know, just want to try something. They were in bliss. Because once we go out, right, if you're in controlled environment, our blood becomes dull. You know this? This is science. Doctors say this. When we go out, we get spiritual blood. We get spiritual. You want get all want spiritual blood, right? Just go and try. Just if you go out, you'll get the spiritual blood. That is this mission, right? So for all this to happen, we should actually do our morning rounds properly. Our sadhana should be very, very strong. Or else, in India especially, just give the book and just give a smile. People take books. Correct? You all experience, correct? If you smile it, people take it. But if you tell 10 shlokas with serious face, say, come on. We have heard so much of shlokas, in, especially in South Bangalore. So many mantras, all Brahmanas are here. Correct? It's a happening place for Brahmanas. So many rituals. Correct? So people want to see happy devotees. People come here to see devotees, happy devotees. We all have to become like that, right? That only possible if we do our morning rounds. And also, very important thing is reading something before going for Sankirtan, right? Somebody was, yesterday was there, a new boy. He gave Bhagavad Gita to one guy. He said, there is a banyan tree in Bhagavad Gita. Do you know? Anybody knows there is a banyan tree in Bhagavad Gita? Which chapter? Oh, all Shastric devotees here. Right? There is a banyan tree, yes. Right? If you go to South Bangalore, all people know Bhagavad Gita. Correct? They read all the Bhagavad Gita. They know shlokas. Right? So best way to... What is the best way to learn? To teach others. Right? How do we learn? Teaching others. Right? So if you go out and people ask, where is banyan tree? Oh, I didn't know this. It was a banyan tree in Bhagavad Gita. You go back and read, correct? Whoever gives classes normally, especially I just came in the morning, 4:30, I came by bus. I have to sit and prepare at least half an hour, right? I don't do justice if I don't prepare. So there's impetus to read, correct? So preaching will help, book distribution help to read more Prabhupada books deeper, right? You may think, hey, these guys are going out and selling some stuff. No. We're not into the program of selling, right? We are here to give something, watch what we have, correct? If we don't have that, can you give it to others? If you have 100 rupees in the pocket, you can give some 10 rupees to others, correct? If you don't have 100 rupees, can you give something? We cannot give something to others which we don't have, correct? So what we have? Taste for holy name, taste for reading Prabhupada books. That is what people are wanting from us, correct? We should, if we don't have that taste, we cannot give it to others, correct? We should develop the taste, right? We should develop, like in marketing, you want to sell a product, and if you don't know about the product, what do people say? Go back and learn about this product and come back, correct? You go to public, say, unless you know about this product, you cannot sell this. But this is marketing. Anybody is from marketing here? Any marketing directors here? So, very important, right? We have to read something. Chanakya says, at least you should read one shloka per day. He says, even not even half shloka you should read. Right? So at least before going for Sankirtan, we should read at least one shloka or one purport. That will give some strength. And we can connect, you know, when you explain to others, right? If we don't tell Prayojana, we discuss this. We discuss what we discussed? Sambandha, Abhidevya, Prayojana. If we don't connect this thing, people say, because everybody is selling something. Correct? It'll be one more selling boy came, right? So that we have to properly connect, then easy to connect with us. We are going out, we want people to give their heart, not money. Correct? Money comes with the heart. It's a secret, background secret. Correct? We want people to connect by heart, right? The one thing yesterday everybody liked when we were doing the book distribution is create that personal connection, right? Preaching is one-to-one. Nityananda Mahaprabhu is preaching one-to-one, not one-to-many, correct? It's one-to-one program. Krishna deals with us one-to-one, right? Not with one-to-many. Did any devotees, I mean, they say that... people become devotees, the preaching happens when we come out of this Basasan. Not in the class, right? We all became devotees, somebody spent some time with us, correct? One to one. You all agree? We had some personal connection with others, some devotee, some sadhu, right? Then only we connected to this movement. Not that every day we came to class and became devotees. Maybe it's a first start attending classes, but somebody had some deep connection with us, correct? We all have that connections, correct? So we are actually going out to get that connection, right? We are going out to people to connect with us. So be personal. Be like a very personal, then they will give their heart to us, right? We're actually going out to preach, right? Not to make money, correct? Money is part of the program, right? So, what we're discussing, Nityananda Mahaprabhu and Haridas Thakur went and knocked all the doors. And what they're saying? Please take up this mission, right? We should also say the same thing. Please take up this mission. This humility is super important, right? Typically, when we go out and people don't take books, say, this is a sinful guy, you know. We all came through the same thing, right? The best part, one thing in book distribution is leave good impression. Very important, right? You know what is ripe soul? You heard in seminar? Now, what is ripe soul? A tree has many fruits, okay? And one fruit is very ripe, one fruit is just coming up, one fruit is not that ripe, you know, it's sour, right? So, if you eat the sour fruits, you don't feel tasty, correct? If you touch the ripe, you feel very tasty, correct? So, when we go out, there's something called ripe souls. After so many lifetimes, they're just waiting. When these Hare Krishna people will come, I'm just waiting, correct? And some are not ripe. So what do you deal with unripe souls? What do you deal? How do you deal them? You tell Bhagavad Gita, you tell Chaitanya Charitamrita, you tell Bhagavatam. They say, what they call? They call? Unripe souls, right? Just leave them. They will become ripe, right? Maybe some people are staying next to our temple for so many years. They don't even come here, correct? What do they call? You are coming from all the way, maybe some north part of Bangalore or somewhere west or whatever it is. But they stay close to us. Do they come here? No. What do they call? Unripe souls. Don't get too unhappy with them. Prabhu, you are staying next to temple, you can't come. You are a foolish guy. Just leave them. They will become ripe, right? Every soul needs some time, right? In Krishna consciousness, we all came. Some people become very fast, right? They come here, they just take up service, they take initiation, they read Prabhupada books. It goes fly by fly. And some people, it takes long time. Because the soul is coming from so many lifetimes. We don't know when it becomes ripe. We go out for picking the ripe fruits. Right? That's our program. There is unripe soul. We say, we'll come back to you. Don't worry. We are just here. There are so many lifetimes to come up. Correct? So, it's important that you don't need to leave that good impression. If somebody says, I'm not interested, correct? That's very important that respect that objection first. Don't get into the, you have to take, because I came. That should not be our mood. So leave that good impression and people will become very happy. And get that mood of humility, what Nityananda Prabhu had, what Haridas Thakur had, that humility, So that's the reason we we all go out and we speak. So we'll take 5 minutes just to, we can reflect back whatever you heard so far, then we'll go further. Anybody like something, whatever struck your heart, anything? You said something. Yes. Very nice. Good. Nice. When Shyam Sundar Prabhu and met George Harrison. You know the story? You heard of the story? You don't know? Okay, I'll tell very quick. You liked it? You like stories? Srila Prabhupada sent this 5 families, Yamuna Mataji, Shyam Sundar Prabhu. They took initiation in San Francisco. And Prabhupada said, go to London and preach. Because Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur had a vision to preach in Europe. Before Srila Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta sent some of his sannyasi disciples to London, but they could not do anything there. They came back. So Prabhupada sent these 5 families, include Shyam Sundar Prabhu, Yamuna Mataji, and all went. They all went. They all went and went to Europe, went to London actually. They want to preach Krishna consciousness. And it's a big task, uphill task, correct? All this, there was always a cold fight between US and Europe that time also. So they said, okay, let's do something very big. And let's spread this Krishna consciousness all over the Europe. That's their plan, Shyam Sundar Prabhu. Then that time, these Beatles were very famous. George Harrison, John Lennon, these are Beatles they call. So they were like waving, like wherever they go, thousands, lakhs of people used to come. Then Shyam Sundar Prabhu said, let's preach to this one guy and let's change whole Europe. You know, these are young grihasthas, you know, just, they don't know even Hare Krishna movement, right? But they had one sincerity that to preach Srila Prabhupada. One thing very important, right? If you have that very one goal, I have to do something to Srila Prabhupada every day, you'll all be successful. Correct? Why did Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, what did he say to Prabhupada? Right? Whenever you have money, print books. Right? So Prabhupada just had that one in the mind. He actually prepared himself for 30 years. Prabhupada. Right? And somebody asked Prabhupada, he went to America and preached so many followers, so many temples. Let's think you have not done anything. Even he was successful because he followed his guru. Right? So Shyam Sundar Prabhu, they want to do something good in the Europe. So, you know, all big celebrities, right? How do you catch them? Right? Very difficult. Even to get a simple appointment for Chief Minister of Yedurappa, it's difficult in Karnataka, right? So whenever they go in the front door, they used to leave in the bags because the lakhs of people are there. And Shyam Sundar Prabhu found this trick and finally he went in back door. And as soon as he saw Shyam Sundar Prabhu, hey, where are you, Hare Krishna Dosa? I'm waiting for you. Shyam Sundar Prabhu says to George Harrison will say to Shyam Sundar Prabhu. This actual story should, there is a, people are waiting for this Hare Krishna devotees, right? They're ripe souls. If you don't go, they get lost, right? If you don't even go and catch them, like they may be staying next door, but they're missing this opportunity. We're actually going out to pick those ripe souls. Just waiting for us. We were distributing books in San Francisco, and we went to this Afghanistani Muslim. And we go every year, like we pick spots. We gave Bhagavad Gita to him, and he read it, and he was very inquisitive person. He was like kind of a like knowledgeable person. Next year we went back and we gave Bhagavatam to him, right? And he told, whenever I have problems, I have questions in the mind, I take up these books and read it. He told his realization. And we didn't go in between. And we went, after gap we went. I said, where are you guys? I'm waiting for more books. And we gave Chaitanya Charitamrita after some time, right? So people want these books. How many varieties of books we have? Yes? Almost close. We have 70 type more books, right? We have so many books. Prabhupada gives so many books. Somebody says, I have Bhagavad Gita. Yesterday, there was a French guy. He said, I'm doing non-profit in Tirupati, some villages. He said, I want some Upanishads. Then we gave Ushopanishad the book. A lot of people say, right, I want Gita, Makarandam. They will say some book. So give some book, it will connect to them. You don't need to find for exact title. You just say it's there in Bhagavatam, because Bhagavatam is complete essence, Amala Puranam. It has everything, correct? It has everything. So you don't need to search for the specific thing. I normally give, somebody says, no, okay, take this book. Somebody says, I'm Muslim. Okay, we have Muslim book too. Haridas Thakur is here. So there is always so many ways to connect to the people, right? So good point, Prabhu. So people are waiting for us. If we delay, people will lose taste. So don't delay. Krishna conscious moment is every day. It's like a fire, right? If you have fire in the house, how do you communicate? Let's think you have fire in the house. You are in China. May not China. It's a tough place now. Let's not go there for some time at least. If you go to Japan or wherever, right, you have fire. What do you say? You communicate, right? It's a fire inside. Somehow you say, come on, I have a fire. Please come and help me. Correct? You don't know language. You don't know anything. You communicate. This is something like that. There is a fire. You should communicate. Somehow or other, do something and communicate. People are waiting for us. Good point. Anybody else? Something to reflect back. Humility. Nice. Especially in South Bangalore. If you say, I know Bhagavad Gita, they will ask shlokas. They know every shloka. Madhvas read before taking prasadam. Some read 15 chapter whole Bhagavad Gita recite. Some read 12 chapter. You have seen this? Before taking, some of them, most of them they read. They know full shlokas. They by heart, right? When Prabhupada disciples came to India, they were distributing books in India. And they're all young Americans. They don't know any shlokas. They used to say, Namo Vishnupadaya, Krishna Prishtaya, Bhutalem, Srimate, Bhakti Vedanta Swami. That only thing they know. They were telling, this is a shloka. And everybody is just impressed with the shlokas. This trick books. Right? So, especially when you are in this kind of a zone where people are pandits, correct? It's all pandit area. So people expect you to say something, correct? Like how Gajendra was remembered his shlokas, right? It's important that we also know some prayers, right? Prayers are very potent. You know how Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared? Why did Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appear? Nice, all Shastric devotees. Advaita Acharya prayed intensely. right? For Shaligram Shila. You know which Shaligram Shila is that? Somebody said this. Narasimha Shaligram Shila. Narasimha Shaligram Shila, he worshipped. That's the best trick for book distribution. Top trick. Just pray sincerely. That prayer will help, right? If you want to really distribute more books, just seriously pray. That will definitely work, right? So once you develop this mood of prayers, we'll become humble, we'll become humility. That's all we want, right? It's difficult to get these qualities. If you go for going out, we'll get this quality very easily, right? Anybody like to say something? Good point, Prabhu. Nice. Very nice. Nice. Very nice. You all experience this, right? That unknown is, hugging that unknown is actually gives spiritual blood. You go out today and just feel it. You feel spiritualized. You become like, it's something, when you come back from book distribution, you chant two rounds. There is a taste in it, correct? All in our life, we need some taste, correct? A lot of people go out of Krishna consciousness sometime and they come back, correct? You have seen it? Some people come back, correct? Most of the people come back. You know why? They remember some taste, correct? We all have to try for those tastes. Not every day, at least like we have few tastes in our life. Serving devotees, chanting 16 rounds, or taking prasadam together. You remember those things, right? That is actually the one we are trying to get, right? Because we got the taste from somebody, correct? Like we had a good time with Pramod Nithai Prabhu in his house. Vaishesh Prabhu was there. We had some family attraction, right? There was a family mood. That's a taste, correct? Because in material world, it's very difficult to get that mood, correct? If you go outside, it's very harsh environment, right? People say, okay, what's in it for me, correct? How do I make sense, correct? But only devotees have that selfless relationships because we center on Krishna, correct? We have that feeling, right? If you have that feeling, devotees will stick to us, right? If we don't feel that family, how long will continue? We didn't came for Prabhupada's mission by hearing philosophy or class, correct? We came out of love. Some devotee has showed some love to us. Some devotee has gave some good connection to the heart, correct? That is called taste. If we get that taste, we'll stick to this moment, right? And if we give that taste to others, they'll also come to us. Good point. Yes, Prabhuji. Correct. Nice. Correct. Considering we are instruments for Krishna service. Very good mood. You should all have it. Good point. Clap to Mataji. Nice thing. Good points, Prabhuji. Very good points. If you have that mood, Anyabilashita Shunyam, Gnana Karma Dhanavrutam, Anukulena Krishnasya, Shilanam Bhakti Ruttamam. This is the mood. We should be going out, right? If you have something, you know, I'm so-and-so from ISKCON temple. I'm a department in charge. I came here. Can you put a chair here? No, it won't work. And that mood of an instrument will really give joyness. Not just in book distribution, in real life, right? We all have expectations, correct? In our life. At least I have it. We all have expectation on others, on our spouse, on our family, at least on us, correct? Oh, I should become like this, I should become like that. You know who will be happy? Have less expectations, right? If you have more expectations, you don't get it, right? If you keep it very simple, then you'll become happy, right? Keep your expectations. Be merciful to yourself also sometime. Don't be harsh to yourself, right? We always think, I have to, that devotee is giving nice class. I want to become like this. Or he's doing nice kirtan. I want to become like this. It's good to learn, good to be inspiration. But Krishna also gave some good quality to us. Krishna gives everybody some good quality, right? If we develop that, that's good enough. Krishna is Bhavagrahi Janardana. He doesn't see how much you have done. Even small, Krishna sees that bhava, right? You, okay, I'm going for book distribution today. I will do 100 books, challenge, right? You're giving high expectations. You'll get frustrated. Krishna doesn't see. Just do, go out and give one book. Krishna is happy with you, right? That is Bhavagrahi Janardana. There is a top book distributor in the world, just missing in my mind. He stays in Los Angeles. Bhrigupati Prabhu. You heard of him? Anybody? Bhrigupati Prabhu. You know what he does every day? He's still in number 2 or number 3, I don't know. Every single day, he gets up morning, he stays in Los Angeles, New Dwaraka Dham. He gets up, he chants his rounds, he does Mangalarti, very simple devotee. He doesn't even talk. It's difficult if you have to talk to him. Only question to answer. He just goes there and after prasadam, he takes the books. He goes to Hollywood Street. Anybody been to Hollywood? I've been to Hollywood. So he goes to Hollywood Street and just stands showing the books. People take the books because of his purity, right? Purity is the force, right? Prabhupada was like that, you know? A single man doesn't have a penny, right? Why do Prabhupada was chanting in that Thompson Square Park? Just by this chanting, so many people got attracted, right? Because of purity. Prabhupada eyes, you see Prabhupada eyes, very pure, correct? So that is what we have to develop, right? And set our expectations low. Don't be harsh to ourselves. It's like we should grow simple. Do one by one, right? They say in, if Sachin Tendulkar has to hit a 6 in the match, how many days he'd have practiced? Correct? Maybe one day? No, right? From every day he used to practice. He practiced only little by little, correct? He would have practiced 24 hours and win the match? No, correct? If you do little by little every day, that's actually the practice, it's called sadhana. If you do little by little, grow little by little, don't jump, you'll fall down, right? So just learn few verses. If you're chanting 8 rounds, increase by 2 rounds. Do one by one, you'll be successful. Win the race. Like Vaishnava always says, like win the battles, right? The small battles. I want to come Mangalarti weekly once. Anybody has a goal like this? To come to temple Mangalarti? We all have, right? At least twice, thrice, or at least on festivals. But it's sometimes we lose the battles. We fight to ourselves. They say that if you practice any habit for 40 days, anything 40 days, it will become like a habit. It's a management, correct? But if you win your battles little by little, you'll become successful, right? So set your expectations low, like how Vamana Dev. He asked only for three steps, right? But he conquered the whole, everything, correct? So start with small and keep the prayers in the mind. The attitude is very important in any service you do. And what does Krishna say? Krishna sees the bhava. That bhava is important. Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur used to say, don't be anxious to see Krishna. Do such an activity that Krishna sees you. Right? We all go to Balaji, rushing everybody, pulling, pumping. How much time we'll see Balaji? Milliseconds maybe. And people complain that they say, I don't want to go there. It's too much rush. Right? We complain that it's too much for me to go there. I keep photo at home and see Balaji. If you see the Suprabhatam, if anybody heard Suprabhatam, this nice verse. It says, even demigods cannot see Balaji more than a minute. If you see more than a minute, Jai Vijay will beat them. Not just us, it's for even demigods. Right? It's very difficult to take darshan of Balaji, right? So we should behave in such a way that Krishna sees us. That is our parampara, Gaudiya Vaishnavism. We don't be anxious in going to different darshans, this program, that program. But if we do engage in the service and sthane sthita, stay in one place, and do your service. What is attachment to Krishna? Attachment to service. Correct? We all have to become one day, we should develop that attachment. Right? The only attachment to Krishna is attachment to service. Whatever you do, you may be cooking, you may be cleaning, you may be doing management, you should like it. Right? If you don't like it, why do we do every day? Correct? It's a tough thing to do every day. Correct? Who will do every day same thing? People go to office, they get tired. When this Friday will come? I want to get out of this place. Nobody likes it. Correct? They just do it for sake of doing. But Krishna consciousness, every day is new day. Every day is a blissful day. But we have to make it fun. Right? If it is not fun, why you will do it anyway? When it's very tough, people just don't do it after some time. Correct? So we have to make Krishna consciousness fun and easy. When you make fun and easy, we can do this thing every day. It's fun? Anybody like to say something? You're saying something. Correct. Nice. Tapasya. Okay. Yeah, austerity. So, and of all the movements, Mahaprabhu make this movement very simple. Just distributing this love of Godhead. Correct? And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu actually, if you see Gaura Leela, right? Why did Mahaprabhu came? To understand mood of Radharani. Correct? And Radharani says, better don't get into it, you'll get shock. It's very difficult to understand mood of Radharani. What is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu trying to do? He's trying to learn the mood of Radharani, want to give it to others. It's like a 440 volts current. You touch it, experience it, and give it to others. Is it difficult or easy? Very tough, correct? That's the reason Nityananda Mahaprabhu came and helped, who is actually the, who want to distribute this, understand this mood and distribute this to others, right? Even though Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was came to understand mood of Radharani, and also we have Gadadhar Pandit. Who is Gadadhar Pandit? Yeah. So if Mahaprabhu came to understand mood of Radharani, why did separately Gadadhar Prabhu came? Right? It's a personification. Right? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is driving the car without license, but Gadadhar Prabhu has full license. He's guiding Chaitanya Mahaprabhu that you should drive like this with a full attention. So that's the reason praying to this Pancha Tattva, right, makes our life very easy. Because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has all the incarnations. You saw Shadbhuj Avatar, there is any picture. Shadbhuj Avatar you have seen any time? What is there? We have six hands. You have seen it? What are the two hands belong to? Represent? Lord Rama. Right? What are the other two represent? Krishna. What do the other two represent? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu with Danda and Kamandala. Right? That's a Shadbhuj Avatar. Right? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also is considered as Narsinga. Narasinga, right? Where does Narasinga Dev come in Chaitanya Leela? All saints here, right? When Mahaprabhu Chankazi was obstructing this whole movement, he said, we went to the dream and said, let me do this thing to you, like Prahlad, like Hiranyakashipu. And if you don't stop this, I will repeat, I've heard in this, right? So Mahaprabhu is in all the avatars. Is Gaura. Is there in Narsinga avatar. Gaura Narsimha. Right? Where else Mahaprabhu is there in Chaitanya, as a Narsinga Leela, in Chaitanya Leela? What else are places? Yes. Nice. Yeah. When he was chanting the mantras, when he heard about Narsinga, he becomes immediately like Narsinga Dev, right? Even we just discussed Advaita Charya prayed to Narsinga Shila, right? That's also one of the... So, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is there in all the incarnations, right? Is Gaura, Kurma, Gaura Narsinga, Gaura Rama, everything. So if we are actually followers of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, but we are Rupanugas. Who is our Acharya? Rupa Goswami. Correct? So if we all follow what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said and have that mood of going and giving what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, we'll all become happy, right? So if we don't do or remember Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, like Prabhupada's mentioning, things will become very tough. So how to remember Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? Mission? What is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mission? Once again. Chant Hare Krishna and teach others. So Srila Prabhupada is very merciful to us. With all the hardships, he wrote so many books, right? Our parampara is, what is our family business? Distributing these books, right? We have book, our family business. So, Prabhupada gave this nice service to all of us, right? We're all warriors in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's whole war. We are fighting against war. What are these books are? These books are smart bombs. You know what is smart bomb? Yeah. Explore any time. You are putting these smart bombs everywhere. We don't know when they will blow. Be careful. Someday this hall may not fill up. You need more 5-story building which are constructing. Correct? We may not know when Prabhupada started mission in India, when people used to go for book distribution, everybody, we are not like, we are outcasted people. You know that? Very difficult to distribute. Now ISKCON is a brand, right? So you go and say, I'm from ISKCON Hare Krishna Temple. Oh, You're all smart people. They respect you, right? How did it happen? Did it happen by chance? No. Lot of devotees went and put these smart bombs everywhere, right? And after 30 years, 40 years of ISKCON, we have now some flourishing, right? We are respected. We are being considered as a good people, correct? It took time. How did it happen? By distributing these books, right? So we are putting smart bombs everywhere, and they'll blow one day whole Bangalore, right? So don't worry that we may think, oh, I gave it to, because as soon as we give the book, he may be eating non-veg, he may be doing some alcohol drinking or whatever. Don't think that whoever you give books, they'll become devotees. He may not become, somebody else in his house will become, correct? Our life is only next 20, 30 years, but Krishna's time is very big. We can't see that, correct? Somebody will see it, correct? So our only service, why we are going out, to please Srila Prabhupada, correct? And for our own self-purification. Whatever happens, if it goes, it's great. If it doesn't go, it's also great, correct? Be in that mood. And give it to everybody. Don't hesitate. Right? As soon as we see people, our logic runs. Oh, this has money. It doesn't have tilak. Or it doesn't look good. He's chewing pawn. We are all spirit souls. Correct? Talk to the soul. Very important. Just talk to the soul. Not to the externalities. Don't see person illiterate having money or... You know, people who have a lot of money, they don't take books. I mean, it's in general, they are too busy, right? Simple people take more books, correct? Don't differentiate by this external looks. Don't put your logic, A is equal to B, B is... Spiritual life is not like that. Spiritual life, 2 into 2 is 10. It's not 4. We don't know what is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's plan. We don't know what is Krishna's plan. We are only instruments. Just execute it. Not anything can happen. Right? Put the smart bombs everywhere. So that's what Prabhupada wants, right? If he continues to do it and get some taste, and that's what we all want to become madhyamadhikaris, correct? We don't want to stay at low level, right? So book distribution will help us to learn, preach. Wherever you go, you are going in a bank, you're all highly qualified people here, great people. You go to bank, you're in metro, wherever you carry books, very important. You all have bags, right? Keep some books, right? If you see some people, Hare Krishna devotee, what they say? You have Bhagavad Gita? Then what you will say? Come to South Bangalore, Kumaraswamy layout, you'll get book there. He will come? He'll not come. You're missing an opportunity, right? As soon as I see Hare Krishna people, they'll say, give Bhagavad Gita, but we don't have, right? Please carry books. You have cars, big cars, keep Bhagavatam set. We all have experience. People say, can you give this book? And we don't have the books. Especially in Bangalore, you should carry Kannada, Telugu, what else? Hindi, Tamil, right? Carry some books. At least you can open up and read. You have so much time every day, correct? Busy manager always have time, is saying, correct? You are cooking, you can do anything. You can just in between, you can read. You're standing in a queue, you're traveling to work, and you have a lunch break, you have a snack break, you have a coffee break. You get all the time 10 minutes. That's all you have to read. Right? So, very important to carry the books wherever you go. Even you can carry prasadam. People, little prasadam. Give it to people. They'll be happy. Right? People like food, right? We're Hare Krishna devotees. We are foodies. We like food. Correct? The how much we eat, people say they'll get afraid. That much we eat. We eat a lot of sweets. Yeah, so What do we say, Prabhu? We stop now, it's 10 o'clock. That's how normal time is. Yeah. Can we take some few reflections or few things we heard so far? And whatever you heard so far, which you liked it, or you have any questions, something to ask? Yeah, good thing. Especially I see a few Maharajas I know, they always carry a prasadam. Especially you carry in a steel box, little bit if possible, give out little by little, they'll feel very happy. Right? Prasadam is, it'll change their consciousness. Like in Ratayatras and all, we give first prasadam and ask for take two books. Because as soon as he takes prasadam, he'll have different thoughts. Tadan, tadman. Right? They say, right, if you want to know about a person at home, whom you have to see? You have to see wife. If she's happily cooking, everybody will have same consciousness. Correct? Because we offer it to Krishna, they'll get good consciousness. Correct? So, very important. Anybody has something to share? Mataji. Yeah. Bhavagrahi Janardana. That's the one? Correct. 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 Yeah, Krishna's time is long. Correct? Because we may not see the results. A lot of people have this question. Prabhu, we have distributed 10,000 books. There are only 100 devotees here. What is the proportion? A lot of people have this question. Oh, book distribution doesn't work. We have to do bhakti vrikshas, bhakti vrikshas. It's important. We should cultivate. But we all, how many people came through books in this room? By just reading some books, somebody gave a book to you in Hare Krishna movement. At least few, right? Most of the people came to Krishna consciousness through books, right? So, you don't know what will happen. Right? These are, as a timed will decide. What we should do, we should continue to do what we can do. Especially I've seen temples who are engaged in service by giving this, having this attitude of giving, right? If you have this attitude of giving, your life will be very happy. Even in spiritual life, in family life. Correct? In family life, we also have a lot of troubles. You should tend to give more. Correct? Then you will have intact in family. Right? Sometimes, initially there will be a lot of connection between spouse. After some time, it's a duty-bound connection. Correct? But you should still give. Right? It's like a two bank accounts. You know this concept? Your spouse and you have two bank accounts. It's your own account, but you have to keep depositing now. After some time you can take, right? First you have to deposit. What is a deposit? It's love, right? Loving and caring. You keep depositing, sometimes you can take back. But initially you have to deposit without expectations, right? Same with relationship, same with friendship, anything, correct? Anybody like to add some things? Correct. 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 Nice. Yes. And also Prabhupada said, don't give Bhagavatam class when you give books. Right? Because everything is there in the book. All we have to do is, we are doing courier job. Just connect. Right? And when they read, because this Prabhupada said, these books are my spiritual ecstasies, right? Because it's, when Prabhupada went to US, his books are already went to New York Central Library. You know this? The books already went. And Prabhupada is to go to every day to see his books are there properly or not. That much he liked his books. Right? When somebody says, Prabhupada said, read Krishna book. His own book, what he wrote. But Prabhupada said, I didn't write these books. Krishna wrote these books. So that was the mood, right? So when people start understanding this, even it's not like they have to become philosophical people, but if they start, like what we read, we get the taste for it. Right. Any last comments, Mataji? Yes. Yes. Very nice. Leave good impression. Very important. If somebody doesn't take, don't get into things. They will come back, right? They'll come back to us, right? Give that good impression. Okay, thank you. And give some prasadam. Or give some Hare Krishna mantra card. Give some sticker, temple card, whatever you have. Give something, right? Like they say, right? If you want, somebody has to give money, fundraiser is called friendraiser. You have to give 8 times, then you can ask somebody. You know this? You have to give 8 times, then you can ask, expect somebody, something from him. So keep giving, right? Your neighbors, your colleagues, your spouse maybe. Keep giving, right? Someday they will reciprocate, right? But leave that good impression, right? Yesterday we were close on this. We were distributing and one devotee was distributing. That Mataji and kids, they didn't take. Kids want book and mother and father is saying, don't take, don't take, don't take. I know, because as soon as you take the book, their kid will be different person. But we were calm, you know, we were just, you know, we don't want to get into an argument, right? So they went ahead and we said, didn't say anything, we gave prasadam. And same father came back, like went back, like maybe of 10 minutes he came back. He said, can you give that book, right? So leave that good impression. People like us. We are Hare Krishna devotees. They like our smile. Give good smile. Hare Krishna. We'll stop here, Prabhu. You like to announce how we want to do this? Like somebody can, because in book distribution, very important thing, you all have to understand, you must organize, right? Very important. Organization is very important. Somebody organize this temple. There is an altar, there is a timings, there is Prabhupada, there is Arati, everything, right? If you don't organize, people won't come here, correct? We have to become organized. Prabhupada made, there was no Gaudiya Vaishnavism. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur made an organization. He took a trouble to create an organization. And Prabhupada created trouble to organization. We have to organize properly. And then we can become more effective, right? So, anytime, even you want to go next time book distribution, carry some prasadam, proper bags. If you're carrying some devotees taking with you, they should also get some impression, good impression, right? Or else next time you will not come. Correct? We have to go alone. It's very tough. We need company. Kalo Sangha, Shakti. How did Shakti will come in Kali Yuga? By Sangha, right? If you have Sangha, we'll get Shakti. If you all go out, like we have maybe 70 people, if we go out, we'll all get Shakti. If you're only like 5 people go out, it's a little tough. Thank you.